Good day, everybody. J7409 here with everyone. Have you noticed, folks, that we've had four named storms over in this area this year so far for the hurricane season? But I want you to look at these sea surface temperatures. Boy, the cold water is coming down from the ice that's melting up north, and it's affecting our sea surface temperatures. Now, yes, that's 81 there. That's no big deal at all. Let's just down some more now. And I'm sure that you have noticed if we come over here. Oh man, the storm's popping off over here like crazy this year. Like crazy this year. But have you noticed? They always travel to the west to stay in the warm water. And this is always cooler, okay? This is always a little cooler. When it starts to get up here, they start to dissipate. Well, what's going on over for the Atlantic? Let's put this back up so we can see the coast of Africa. It seems that what is happening is that it's the El Nino, okay? Now it seems that NOAA and the National Hurricane Center is thinking that the hurricane season for the Atlantic might be below normal, and I'm beginning to think maybe it will too. Now, this is not to say there's not going to be any hurricanes that we have to watch out for. Don't even go there because we will. We'll have to keep our eyes open. But it's seeming that the 2018 hurricane season is shaping up to be a little below normal. And all of the experts, okay, they're now expecting fewer hurricanes than they predicted in late May. Yay, that's a wonderful good thing. Now, there are still more storms to come, as I just mentioned. The hurricane season is far from being over, so don't think we're not going to have any. I mean, we may not. I still think we are with what I said a couple of weeks ago about the Gulf Coast states and maybe Texas and even North Carolina. But that doesn't mean it's going to materialize. It doesn't mean it won't. Now, 9 to 13 named storms, including 4 to 7 hurricanes and 0 to 2 major hurricanes of category 3 strength or higher, are predicted this year. And of course, hurricane season started June 1st and it runs through November 30th. Now, the forecast number includes the four named storms that have already formed this year, which is, of course, Alberto, Beryl, Chris, and Debbie. Now, an average 6-month Atlantic season typically produces around 12 named storms, of which 6 become hurricanes, including 3 major hurricanes. And the latest forecast is well short of what the Atlantic experienced last year when we had 17 named storms that formed and 3 major hurricanes struck the U.S. Last year's season ended with 10 hurricanes and 6 major hurricanes. Now, the 2018 season will see a below normal number of storms in the Atlantic basin. They think that there's a 60% chance of that happening. That's up from 25% in the original forecast back in May, when it looked like the basin would experience an average to above average season. Now, the likelihood of a near normal season is now 30%. And the chance of an above normal season has dropped from 35% to 10%. As usual, the latest forecast cannot offer a bit of information most critical to everybody who lives in hurricane-prone areas. Now, where these storms might strike. But of course, we all know the zone extends from the Gulf Coast of Texas around Florida to the Carolinas and sometimes as far north as Boston. Now, El Nino, it could make for the fewer storms that we're having. Now, last year's season was very active. We all know that, in part because of a weak La Nina that developed during the 6-month hurricane period. La Nina is a naturally occurring phenomena It's characterized by cooler than normal water in the eastern Pacific equatorial region. While La Nina occurs in the Pacific Ocean, it has a widespread impact on the global climate. That includes decreased wind shear, the changing of wind speed and direction, and height. Now, all of this, it affects all of this across the tropical Atlantic, which creates favorable conditions for tropical development. Now, La Nina in 2017 made way for what became iso-neutral conditions, meaning neither La Nina nor its opposite El Nino was present. There was neither one. Okay? Now, there's still that chance that El Nino could develop later this season. We'll have to wait and see. But now there is nearly a 70% likelihood of El Nino forming during this year's hurricane season. And this is according to the Climate Prediction Center. El Nino features warmer water in the eastern Pacific equatorial region, which we've seen all of these storms popping off in the Pacific, creating greater wind shear in the Atlantic, and thus fewer tropical storms for all of us over here. Now, if El Nino does develop by October, it could possibly shut down or weaken the latter part of the season. But that is certainly no guarantee, okay? And if El Nino fails to appear, we could certainly see the seasonal activity near the higher end of the percentage rate. We're going to have to wait and see if it happens. Sea surface temperatures. Now, we all know they play a part across the tropical Atlantic and the Caribbean Sea, and also they continue to remain much cooler than average. Yes, they're hot, but not as hot as they usually are at this time. Now, of course, all hurricanes use warm ocean waters to fuel and build in intensity and size. And with the cooler ocean temperatures, hurricane development should be below normal. Not saying we're not going to have any. I still think we are. We have a chance of some, okay? Now, cooler temperatures combined with strong wind shear and drier air in the region where storms typically develop will further suppress hurricanes. So, this is what it's looking like right now. A lot of it, call it climate change, call it whatever you want, my friends. The temperatures are the air temperatures are outrageous. The ice is melting, okay? All up in here. And it's affecting the water temperatures. This is the only little real hot spot. It does carry over into the Caribbean and up in the Gulf and up the eastern coast a tad, okay? But if you remember just a few short weeks ago, maybe a month ago, excuse me, up in Maine they were having all of these warnings about do not get in the water because the temperatures were so hot, but the waters offshore were still very cool. So let's pull this down, and this is what it's looking like today off the coast of Maine as far as the water temps, 61 degrees, compared to when you come down off of my coast, 83 degrees, and when we get down off the coast of Florida, 84 degrees. While we're doing this, let's check out the Gulf right quick. What's it looking like? We can get it to come up. Well, the Gulf doesn't want to cooperate this morning. Here we go, 86 degrees. The Gulf's the warmest place. And if you recall what I said a few weeks ago during the live show, I said there may be a possibility of a tropical storm threat around this area coming up maybe late this month or early next month, and maybe a hurricane may happen. Form from all of this stuff over in this area. I also think that there is a chance that maybe from North Carolina all the way down, we may have a hurricane threat of some sort in September. We'll have to wait and see what it looks like and how it all plays out right now. But I'm telling you, people, El Nino, La Nina, and all of the ice melting making the cooler waters is what's hampering why we haven't already had a hurricane. I'll make this map a little bigger. Now you can see off the coast of Africa better. You can see our eastern coast of the US going through the Caribbean up into the Gulf and over in the eastern Pacific, where all of these storms in the past few days have materialized. But most of them, when they head up north, you see how the water is cooler. All of this is affecting our wind shear, our El Nino, our La Nina, and everything else. Plus, we got these cool waters coming down. So this stuff is in favor for everybody on the East Coast. Once again, this is not to say we're not going to have a tropical storm or a hurricane hit U.S. soil this year, because we probably are going to have that chance to happen. As you can see, they pop off of Africa. This is today, okay? This is this morning. They pop off of Africa, they come up, they go across, and boom, 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 there is Hector, remnants of Christy, John. Debbie's out here. She's dissipated already. Debbie's nothing. Don't worry about her, as you can see right here. But see what I'm talking about, people? This water and the dry Saharan air, which all factors into El Nino and La Nina, they're not making up. They're keeping the storms from forming until they get over in this area, and they seem to be traveling that warm water path instead of moving up. Now, we do have to watch if they start to move up in the Gulf or across Cuba and ride the coast. That's going to be an entirely different situation. I found this quite interesting. I wanted to share it with everyone. It's good news in a way. Hey, that's great news in a way. We all should be very happy for that, because we still are going to have a chance of some tropical storms or hurricanes to develop before the hurricane season is over. We've just got to watch all these elements and see how it plays out. Let's move up real quick as we end this video to tomorrow, and you can watch these systems as they move and how they start to try to form, but they don't always make it. We'll go up to Sunday around 1 p.m. See, that you thought was going to be something's already fizzled out. Okay, it's nothing. Then we have these coming off the coast. We'll go up to Monday. And this is the European model. If it was anything, it would show it with no doubt. Tuesday, 3 p.m. Now we got the Congo line going on again, and you can see it starting over here again, okay? See how they're following that path? Here's Wednesday around 5 p.m., the 15th. And Thursday around 9 p.m., the 16th. Now, this little system is trying to have some rain, but that's about it. Nothing looking like it's going to develop. We'll watch it. We'll go to the 17th around 7 p.m. And you can see they keep coming off of Africa. They want to come off and form, but they just don't make it. All right, 1 a.m. Saturday, the 15th. And we'll go up to as far as we can around 6 p.m. today, the 19th. And we got a great big high right here. We do have this low up here, but it's just, I don't believe it's a storm at this point by any means. It's just a low pressure system. But there you have what's going on there. We still have some coming off here. When I think some will form or have a chance of forming is going to be down towards the end of the month. And I mean the end of the month, around the 29th or the 30th. We'll have to wait and see what happens. But I found this information, wanted to share it with you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe, click the bell, check off the email notification. Make sure you get all the latest in weather news, forecast, watches, warnings, and tropical information and updates. I love you guys so much. Feel like I know each and every one of you personally. I just appreciate everything you do for me. Everybody have a good day, a safe day, and peace, love, and kindness to all.